Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. This is Naveen. In this video, we are going to discuss about the introduction about CSS. So what is CSS, the cascading style sheet? So in this, we will discuss what is the syntax of CSS and what are the different selectors available in CSS, and also how to apply the CSS with the HTML. So how to develop a project with the CSS. So all these rules we're going to discuss now. Okay, so this is an introduction video for CSS. Okay, so let's start. So let's have a look here. This is my screen. And you want to start the CSS first, you have to create a folder. So let me create a folder, CSS. Okay, so let me open this folder in my WebStorm. So let me open the CSS folder. Let me copy the address. So let me open the WebStorm. So file, open, paste, okay, okay. So now I got the CSS has been loaded here. Okay, so in this, let me start live server meanwhile. So live minus server space minus minus port equal to 9000. Click on enter. So live server has been started. Yeah, no files at all. Okay, fine. Now let me create one normal HTML file. I do one thing. I create a simple directory. Some 01 underscore CSS basics. Okay, so in this, I create another HTML. Like 01 underscore CSS underscore basics. Okay, so HTML has been created. So let me change the title, CSS basics. Okay, save it. Let me refresh the browser. So I got CSS basics. In that, I have a HTML file, CSS basics.html, and this is the source code. Fine. So now, what is CSS? So CSS stands for the cascading style sheet. So why we use CSS? We use CSS for if you want to develop any website, so for that you want to apply some styles, right? Like background colors, background images, like padding, margin, transitions, animations, transformations. So for all these type of extra effects, and we all comes under the styles, the presentation, the look and feel of your website. Okay, so for this purpose we're gonna use CSS. If you mix the HTML with the CSS, it will be a proper website and which will be the rich and user friendly. Okay, so that's the purpose we're going to use the CSS, and it is having various different syntaxes. Okay, so let's have a look how to use the CSS here. So if you want to use the CSS with the HTML, we have some three different scenarios we can apply. But before we understand the scenario, we should understand the syntax of CSS. So the main syntax of CSS is, let me go to Notepad, open this. Yeah, let me change the language to CSS. Yeah, see here, the syntax of CSS will be like this. Here, something like body will be there, open, close. Inside, you will be having something called background color. Red, like this. So this type of syntax, and something called padding, some 10 pixel semicolon. So generally every CSS will have this type of syntax. So in this, let's understand what is what. This is called as the selector, the CSS selector. Okay, and from here the style starts, from here the styles ends. And what is this background color is called the CSS property. And what is this red is called the properties value. And this is the statement ends, end of the statement, okay, end of your styles. And then this is the next property. So the general approach of CSS here is, we are going to select a particular HTML elements. On top of that, we are going to apply the styles. So how are you going to apply the styles is, for every style, there is a property and set of values. So suppose what type of style? Suppose I want to apply some background color. So background color is a property, and what type of color you add? You want to add red, black, blue, all these colors. So these colors are called as values. So see, what I have done is body. I have just selected this call the CSS selector. So I have selected the body tag. On top of that, I have applied some styles. So this is called a property and this is one property. So background minus color is a property, key is a property, CSS property and its value. So this is how we're going to apply the styles. Okay. But now if you want to attach these styles to the HTML, there are some three different ways. So how you attach the styles is, okay, the ways of adding styles. So mainly three ways you can add. The very first one is inline. So inline approach. And the second one is internal approach. And the third one is external approach. Okay, so let's start now. So inline approach, internal, external. So what is this inline is, you're gonna apply the styles using a style attribute. You're gonna apply the styles to the HTML using the style attribute. So let's have a look how we apply the styles with inline approach of CSS. Now, let me go to my HTML. In this, there is no data here. Let me write a H1 tab. I say good morning. Okay, let me check the browser. I got good morning. Now I want to apply this colors, some styles for this. So what to do? Using inline approach, style attribute. So I say H1 tag style is equal to background color like orange. Now save it. Go check. Not here. Here. See, you got that color orange. See, this is the way we can apply the inline styles. Okay. Now I have another H1, something called good afternoon. Okay. Now what? Good afternoon is not apply the styles. So I want the same background color for good afternoon as well. So what you do is, they say style, background color, orange. Now again, good afternoon, orange color. Next, I want another H1. Something called good evening. Okay, now check. Good evening not having any styles. If you want to apply the same styles, so what you do is style, background color is a property and orange is the value. So you get like this. See now, I have three H1 tags, but all the three H1 tags I have applied the same styles. Yes, this how the inline styles of CSS will work. But there is some limitation. There are some limitations with the inline approach. What are the limitations? The first limitation is, what is this one? It is the background color orange. Which language it belongs to? It is CSS. And what is this one? It is HTML. So the first limitation in this approach is, you are just mixing the CSS styles with the HTML. If you develop any example like this, see here, only hardly one property is there. It like this. If I add some other property like padding some 10 pixels, so some padding applied. I say color red, color white. If I keep adding something called text align center, if I keep adding the styles like this in this way, see, it's very hard to understand where the CSS starts and where the HTML starts. Okay. So the first limitation in this approach is, there is a mixing of HTML tags and the CSS styles. That's the first one. And second one, what are we doing here? All H1 tags, we got the same styles, but for that, to achieve that scenario, what you have done? What I have done is background color, orange, orange, orange. So the styles has been duplicated. You know, in software industry, never encourage the code duplication. Okay, you must not do the code duplication. What is the problem in that code duplication is maintenance. Code maintenance problem will come. What is that is, suppose you change orange, it is applied orange. Now your manager says, hey, not orange, I want to be green. So what you do? Only three tags are there, you can just change to something called lime green. It's changed to lime green. So like this, you have to copy, paste, pay. So what happened? All change to green. So here, only three lines are there. We can just make it. Assume in your website, there are some thousand places you have to change. So what do you do? You have to change everywhere, right? That's again burden. It takes a lot of time to change and you have to pick up where it is and you have to change everyone, right? So that's the limitation. The first limitation, mixing of HTML and CSS and code duplication and code maintainability, okay, is extra burden on the developer. So we don't encourage adding these type of styles. So to overcome these styles, to resolve these limitations, we go with the second approach called internal approach. What is this internal approach is? We are going to apply the styles not with style attribute. It is with style tag. It is with the style tag. And where you're going to add the style tag, I show you. Suppose if you want to apply the styles, let me delete all this styles. Okay, so I just removed it. Now go check, no styles apply. Fine. What is this internal approach is? Style tag. And where you write a style tag is? In the head section. In the head section. Okay, I mean inside the header tag. Okay, so what is this is? In the head section, this is the head starts, head ends. So below title, let's write one style tag. So H1, open close. In this, you can write some styles. See, I want to apply the styles for the H1 tag. So I just pick up the H1 and I'm adding the style H1. So in this, what do you want? I want some background color. So let's say the background color, orange, red. All are applied with orange, red. I want to change the color. So color, white. I want to add some padding. Padding, some 10 pixels. Let me add some box shadow. 00, 10 pixels and the black. See, I want text center. So text align center. See, if you add these styles, the first limitation got overcome is there is a clear separation of the CSS styles and the HTML, right? There is no mixing of HTML is separate and CSS is separate. And also one more thing, there is no code duplication. Only one time we write and it is applicable for n number of H1 tags you write, it works. Okay, so this is the way of adding styles is called internal approach. Okay, now but internal also we have some limitation. What is that limitation is? If you add the style tag for this HTML, it means these styles are applicable only for these HTML documents. I repeat, when you write the style tag and the styles for this HTML document, so these styles applicable only for these HTML document only. I want to apply the same styles for some other HTML pages. What to do? Same styles I want for multiple HTML pages. Then you have to copy paste the style tag for each and every HTML page. First, understand why we have to keep the same styles for multiple pages. So I have page number 1 and the page number 2 and the page number 3 and the page number 4. So I have 4 pages. Suppose I have written some 100 lines of code in the page number 1. Okay. See here, this is your page HTML document number 1 and this is 2. And this is 3 and this is 4. Okay, so HTML page, you have written some 100 lines of styles properties in particular HTML document. Now what happened? These styles applicable only for this page. Now I want the same styles for second page also. So what do? You have to copy those lines and paste here and paste here and paste here. Again, what is the problem? Code duplication, right? You want to change the styles again, each and every page you have to go and change. First, tell me why we need to keep the same styles for all the pages. Best example, when you take a website, let's consider some HDFC bank website. Okay. So in the HDFC bank online banking website, if you see the first page, you have some styles, like blue color theme will be there, right? We call theme. Theme means the images, the text, the content, everything like bluish color, right? That's called theme. So for that, we need to write some lot of properties. So first page with blue color theme. Now, when you log in inside, so we have account section, right? So our savings account and all details. Is that red color? Complete page? No, it's a blue color, right? So you go to every page, any page of the entire website, always blue color theme, right? You log out, even blue color theme. So it means in a particular website, they have to maintain the same type of colors and same type of styles for each and every page. This scenario, if you're using the style tag, you have to repeat the same styles for all the pages. All of a sudden, if you want to change the styles for all the pages, you have to do it for each and every page. So inline approach is, internal approach is not suitable. So for that, you have to go for external style sheet. What is that is, you don't need to write all the styles here. You just need to write a separate style.css here. You need to write a separate styles.css. Now what you have to do is, all the pages has to connect to that style.css. So if you change some styles in the style.css, all the pages will get affected. Okay, so this is we're going to use for a website development. Okay, so let's have a look how this works. Now I have let me create new HTML, some 0 to underscore page 1.html. I create another HTML, that is 0 to underscore same page 2.html. So I have page 1 and page 2. Okay, so I say here page 1 as the title, and this one I say page 2 as the title. Okay, so now let me open both in my browser. Let me close this, refresh. Yeah, page 1 I'll open here, and the page 2 I'll open here. So page 1 and page 2. Let me write some styles. So in the page 1, I write some H1 or H2. Let's say welcome to page 1. Okay. Inside I write a paragraph. Let's say lorem 40 tab. So I just written a page 1 and some paragraph. Now go to page 2. I write the same thing, like H1, welcome to page 2. Okay, 2. Then the paragraph, I write some lorem 50 tab. Okay, and that was 40, this is 50. Fine. Now let's check. Here is some content, here is some content. So two pages. Now what I do, in the page 1.html, I write a style tag. I'll say the body tag, the whole body tag, the background color, I say light salmon, and also the font family Comic Sans MS, Sans Serif. So some background color and font family I have applied for this page. We discuss all these properties in a future classes. Just assume background color applied and font I have changed. Now check page 1 applied with welcome to page 1 and some font. What about to page 2? It is not applied any of the style. So what I do, I'll just copy the style tag and paste it in the page 2 as well. So now what happened here and here, same styles applicable. Okay, but what the problem, I want to change the background color. So in the page 1, I change the background color to lime green color. So what happened, only page 1 got changed, page 2 not changed. So you have to go to page 2 and change back to lime green. It is like this. Okay, keep it back, and here also keep it back to light salmon. It is changed. So you want to change anything, you have to go and change it. I don't want this. I want to only one point of contact to change all the pages. So what you have to do is create a separate style.css and have a connection. Okay. So thing is, let me delete the style tag now. And also here, let me delete the style tag. Okay, so now here no styles applicable because I have just deleted the styles. I create one style sheet. So how to create is, that's very simple. Right click, new style sheet. Okay, let me click on the style sheet and I say styles.css. Okay, fine. So in this I say body, again the background color light salmon, and the font family Comic Sans MS, comma Sans Serif. Now save it. Okay, I say text align center also. So I write some styles. Now check, none of the page affect the styles. So why? See, you have HTML and you have style sheet, but you have not connected this CSS with the HTML, right? So I told you have to create and link it. So how to link them is, there is a tag called link tag. Using the HTML link tag, you can connect. Okay, let me connect them. So in the page one, I say link tab. Okay, relationship style sheet and href, you have to give the address style.css. Now what happened? First page has connected with the style.css. So first page applied with the styles. What about the second one? Second one also link, they say style.css. They save it. Now go check. It is like this. So page one and page two applied with the same style. Now what I do, go to style.css. I change the font, only one point of contact, right? I change the font to something called Old English Text Empty. Now check, here it is changed, here also it is changed, correct? Okay, and when I say the font size, some 40 pixels. Now check, here it is changed, here also it is changed. Okay, so like this. So I did it. What happened? Back to original, back to original. Okay, so this is how we're going to develop for a website. Website means you have to create a separate style sheet, or more than one style sheet also you can create, some each module some style sheet, you can do it. Okay, so now let's recap what we discussed till now. When we go for inline, as inline means if you want to apply a styles for a particular tag, okay, because you have to apply the style attribute for the particular tag, only for that tag will apply, and still it is not recommended. Okay, fine. Internal, we use internal for watch for a particular web page or HTML document for a particular web page. And what is external? We use external for a particular website. Okay, so like this, yeah, so like this we're gonna develop websites. Okay, so we're gonna apply the CSS styles for each other page like this. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, and we'll see the CSS selectors in the next video. Thank you.